Get comfortable with losing, you are in for a vortex, downward spiral into oblivion, into oblivion, into oblivion, into oblivion, into oblivion.
Who knows what tomorrow will bring?
It's taken me a while to learn that wisdom sometimes trumps. Wisdom sometimes trumps being competitive.
Never went down, man. Never got me down, man. You hear me? Never got me down.
Maybe sunshine and maybe rain.
Now you wait just a minute, Finster, and Uncle Bugsy will get you something to play with.
The genesis of throwing a knuckleball starts when you can't do much else and you're trying to hang on, to be perfectly frank. I mean, desperation.
Another day. Another day. Just another day. I wanna live.
All right, please, ladies and gentlemen, very quiet, please. Please, we have a lot, ladies and gentlemen, please, we have a lot of people listening to me very carefully. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to sit down, state your name, where you're from, play your song.
Sing the song now.
We're having a party, we're inviting everybody to the party tonight.
Sounds so.
No, I can throw conventional and get guys out.
That means Robert Allen. You know, I don't remember ever being called anything other than RA growing up.
Shoot, I was probably 10 or 11 when I first started tinkering around with it. And then as I got older, I would just kind of play around with it and always had one. But I never really threw it until I got to be in college. And then I would throw it a little more and got a little better.
Until 1996, when I got signed by the Texas Rangers in the first round. And that's kind of where it begins. It's an honor to be on the team.
Third prize is you're fired.
It's not how we fall, but it's how we get up. They had a good plan. You know, he's the consummate professional.
Daddy!
Wheat. Wheat. Lots of wheat. Fields of wheat. A tremendous amount of wheat.
He got it. He knew it. 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 He got it. He knew how to make sure my wrist was in the right place or my arm was in the right angle. But it had some severe movement. And I think that probably alarmed the powers that be.
But he got it, and sometimes you just gotta tip your hat, tip your hat, tip your hat, tip your hat, tip your hat. They did the comprehensive MRI to make sure that everything was okay, and when they did that MRI, it turned up that I didn't have the existence of an ulnar collateral ligament, or the Tommy John ligament, in my elbow. Doctors really couldn't explain it. I was asymptomatic, meaning I didn't have any pain or anything like that. They just couldn't explain it. In fact, I had to take two or three MRIs because they really didn't believe the first one.
And it's hard for that just to disappear, 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 disappear.
Felt like I'd been punched in the gut, but, you know, I did the best I could.
I came up pitching conventionally and had parts of three seasons in the big leagues, throwing regular stuff.
How did that work exactly?
Badly.
Credo of a clown. Credo of a clown. Credo of a clown. A little song, a little dance, a little seltzer down your pants.
When I was in Texas in 2005, I came off an injury, a kind of an upper back injury right behind my shoulder. And when I came off that injury, I didn't regain any of the velocity that I had. And Oral Hershiser was our pitching coach with Texas at the time, and he knew I threw a pretty good knuckleball. And he suggested that I go down to AAA, try to work on it, come back up in September, and try to build off that.
You know, in order just to chase the dream of playing, I had to come up with a weapon,
the weapon, the weapon, the weapon, the weapon. I'd like to take not the safe road, but I knew that once I went down this road, it was either going to be all or nothing. And so I tried to sell out to it the best I could.
Kind of leaving who I was behind, 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 behind. And I'm never going to be that guy again, and letting that be okay, and really embracing who I am.
So I've got to try to stay in that moment with that commitment and do the best I can, and let the results happen.
This is a good petri dish for growing. You got to feel the pain of it for sure. I think it starts there. I think it starts with really feeling the pain of losing. That's it creating a distaste in your mouth, and it being a situation where that just is a grotesque feeling. Because that motivates you to greater heights. To greater heights.
It's a pretty small fraternity.
and historically it's a pretty tight fraternity as well.
Of course, I started tutoring under Charlie Huff.
Guy who really gave me some very appropriate advice.
He told me the first day I saw him, he said it took me one day to learn how to throw a knuckleball and a lifetime and a lifetime and a lifetime to learn how to throw it for strikes.
And then from Charlie Huff, I really got introduced to Tim Wakefield. And Tim has been so generous with all his wisdom and experience. I actually worked with Phil Negro, which was a real honor, last off season, and that was another stepping stone.
But if you look at Necro and Wakefield and Huff, from ages 35 to 42, those guys won over 100 games. So there's a lot of potential to what can happen from really learning and trusting this pitch.
Trust in this pitch.
Sunshine, fresh air. We got the team behind us, so let's play two.